Hey guys, it's Wendy with Hot Chix Cool Toy Review, and we are at Comic-Con 2012 at the Sideshow Collectibles booth with Matt Bischof, and he's going to take us around and talk about some of the awesome pieces that they have here.
Hey Wendy, how are you guys doing today? At this year's Comic-Con is Deadpool Premium Format. The wisecracking anti-hero is here today, and we're showcasing him, and he's got just all geared up with his partial ninja, partial commando bullet base. He's got a rubber chicken with the dynamite up its butt, and for a gag on somebody, he's come with a couple of different portraits, but this is our first Deadpool piece, and we're really, really excited to share with everybody this year. Going back over to this booth, we have all the Avengers, and we have our previous Thor, our Captain America from the film. From the Captain America film, we have Scarlett Johansson's Black Widow, and then we also have this beast, the Hulk, and this is the piece we're really excited to share with everyone, and this is the Hulk based on the Avengers film, as opposed to our previous Hulks, which were more of the comic incarnations of him. So he's there in all his glory, his teeth are glaring and his lips are bare, and he's ready to smack some Chitauri down, and we're really excited to show him as well. So our legendary scale figures that we're showcasing this year, and one of the highlights of this year, are both Galactus as well as this guy right here, Dr. Doom. And Dr. Doom is in prototype form. There's still a little more work we're gonna do on him, but we were just so excited to how he came out that we wanted to share him with everybody. So there's a little more details that might be added, but he's gonna come with a couple different face options at this point. He may have a couple different masks, but I mean, already as he stands, we're really excited about how this project's coming out, and we're excited that everyone can get to see him finally. With our new DC licensed Catwoman, and she's our first figure from the legendary scale size, and another one that we worked on for quite a bit, trying to get all the proportions right and all the gear and everything. She's got an actual real leather whip right here. She's got her goggles.
Is that suit actually fabric?
Yeah, the suit's fabric.
Wow.
So it's just stretched on really tight just to hug the frame of her figure. So she's looking really, really good, and everyone seems to really dig her. So we're really stoked with how she came out. Coming back on this end, we've got Sauron. This is another new piece. And Sauron is really, really pointy, fragile, handle with care, don't poke your eye out. But he's on top of his base, and we've got some of like a paint technique of showcasing light, like, kind of glaring up on his armor off the, you know, lava pit below, you know, Mount Doom. And he's pretty majestic. He's got his fabric material cape in the back. He's got all his armor all chiseled out. This is one of our prototypes. There might be a little tweaks here and there, but this is the target image of what we're shooting for. And we think we'll achieve it with a lot of, make a lot of people really happy. Coming back over with our DC line, we have Joker, we have Poison Ivy, which we're really stoked about. Poison Ivy, we'll have an exclusive and a regular version. The exclusive are her little flower companions. You can switch out the small flowers with the big flowers. She just came out really excellent. Next to her is the man and the cowl, Batman, and Batman's now joining Joker as the premium format line, and he is atop his gargoyle base with his batarang in hang. That's the exclusive. He'll have two different portraits, and we're really, really excited. But it's a sculpted cape this year. I'm not doing a fabric cape, and the sculpted cape really gives a big, nice flow to the detail of him on top of a building top ready to take out some guys. All right, right here we have another premium format joining Batman as Superman. Superman's atop his Fortress of Solitude ice base, and he's got his fabric costume, his fabric super tidies, but he's got another sculpted cape showing the flow. He will have an exclusive version and a regular version, but at this point, this is what our target is for shooting Superman on the premium format scale, and we're really excited to share him this year's Sideshow. We also have both the busts, Batman and Superman. Both of them are pretty hefty, pretty mighty, really showcasing the logos, the detail in the eyes, also the skin texture and everything. Really, really adding more and more of these DC busts to the line. We also have our premium format Green Lantern. The exclusive for this figure is the giant energy punch. They also have a different hand that you can plug in and out, but he's standing on top of his rock base, and he's got that nice candy-colored paint job on him. So another piece of the DC line. We're really excited to work on that.
All right, now one of the pieces that we've been really eyeing, we're going to be looking at the Elvira in Coffin.
Yeah, we're adding another second Elvira piece. This one was been worked on quite a bit, but Elvira is popping on her coffin in her little nightie, and she's a premium format virgin, so she's got fabric top and bottom, and some garters, and silk stockings, and red-lined coffin with candles dripping. Coming around the bend is another piece of the Vampirella line, and Vampirella's premium format. Vampirella's on top of some giant demon dragon skull, looking all sexy. She has two portraits, just like the previous Vampirella did. She had fabric, red onesie, whatever it's called, is all fabric, and the rest is all painted. To the back and rear of her is first piece, Lady Death, and this piece is really awesome. This is a whole bunch of detail, a lot of little pieces, and it's just a really, really great piece. We're really excited to show this one to everybody, but the detail and the sculptures on it's just mimicking the leather so well. She's got a fabric cape with a wire liner in the back, so you can pose it and adjust a little bit, but her hair's flowing, and she's got her scythe, and it's a really, really cool piece to add to our crazy monster female demon ladies line. All right, and joining our bus line, our life-size bus, is the Red Skull. This isn't based on the movie version, obviously, but this is our interpretation of Marvel's Red Skull, Captain America's nemesis, and he's standing past the podium with his cigarette holder, his eyes gazing adrift, and he's got his medals and his Hydra symbols.
And fabric suit.
Yeah, fabric suit top, fabric line right here, collars. These are sculpted pieces right in here. And his eye detail is pretty menacing looking, and just the red skin is stretched right over his skull so tightly, it's pretty creepy. And the cigarette cups right here. And the great piece is to have the Iron Man Mark 7 from the Avengers movie. He's got his little power piece. It will light up, his chest will light up, his eyes will light up. He has the back propulsion jet unit piece right here. So it's another Iron Man bust to add to your War Machine and your previous Iron Man bust that have come out previously from Sideshow. All right, so this year we have two new unveils for the G.I. Joe 6-scale line, and that's the Baroness. Baroness is on this end, and she's our first female figure on the G.I. Joe line on our first new female body. Baroness has all new parts. Everything on her is going to be new from the body up. She's going to come with two portraits. One is with her hair down. The second is with her hair blowing in the wind. They're both sculpted hair. She'll have working on different glasses to include with her, the square frame, the round frame. She's going to have her mech or her Uzi on her hip with clips on the back. The boots will all be a soft PVC plastic, so you get a good, nice posing ability with hard armor parts on her. And she's a really, really great figure, and she's pretty menacing. Alright, the second piece we have for our G.I. Joe line that's new and being unveiled at Comic-Con is Major Blood. And Major Blood came a little bit of a surprise to people. We've been working on him for a while, and he just came out awesome. He's got, this is Sideshow's version of him, so we're not really mimicking any of the versions in the comics and the different incarnations he's been in.
But he's completely recognizable.
He's completely recognizable with the eye patch, the dog tags. Yeah, he's going to have his rockets in the back of him. Rockets in his rocket launcher. He'll have, we'll probably have two portraits. We're not sure exactly what two we're going to use yet, but we're definitely going to have the classic eye patch look that you see here. He's got a giant revolver with brand new holster. Armor will come off, so you can give more of the classic look if you want, or more of this armored, crazy Major Blood look. And he's really, really looking awesome. This is our new Snake Eyes Commando Deluxe version, Snake Eyes and Timber set. Timber is articulated. We previously offered Timber in the Waypoint diorama, but he was just a statue of resin. And this time we made him a little bit bigger, made him a little more beefier, a little more menacing, and now he's articulated. So he doesn't have a huge range of motion, but you can get him in some pretty awesome poses to accompany Snake Eyes on his missions. Snake Eyes comes with both portraits, the classic goggles, as well as his visor. His sweater is removable, so you can slim him down for the more visor ninja look, or you can bulk him up for the commando look with a sweater. Got an all new messenger bag you can fill up with a bunch of gear, bunch of guns, bunch of grenades, got his sword. That's the exclusive head sculpt on Timber. He comes with a more docile one, so when you buy the set, if you buy the exclusive from SideshowCollectibles.com, you can get the growling, menacing Timber. If you buy it somewhere else, you can get the docile one, but if you buy from Sideshow, you'll get both. We also have Falcon making his appearance. Falcon is this year's Comic-Con exclusive, one of three or four. And Falcon has all new sculpted forearms, shotgun, two portraits, tomahawk. He also has new cut and sew shotgun shell pouches on his belt. He's got a radio pouch on his backpack. It's almost a brand new figure. It's not a repaint or anything. So he's a pretty awesome Comic-Con exclusive this year, and we do have him available at Sideshow. Okay, and so this year we're unveiling our entire DC 1/6 line. Well, not our entire, but our first introduction, and we're coming out with five figures. These are all prototypes. They'll be staggered in release. They're not all releasing at one time, so we're not gonna bombard everybody, but we're still working on them. These are our prototypes. These are the targets for the look we're going for with our DC line. It's more of a comic look, not based on the movies or anything like that. This is Sideshow's interpretation with DC's guidance on what we envision these superheroes to look like and villains. We have Superman right here, Batman, Catwoman. If we go turn around to a little bit back, they are joined by Harley Quinn as well as Joker. Now, we have two females that will be joining the Baroness on a new female body, which we're really excited to share. We'll also be doing on these figures a more sculpted muscular body for like Batman and Superman. So we're going to be adding more bodies to our foundation body line to join the Prometheus. Joker is a top here. Joker is the first one that probably will see release out of production. He is tailored up, man. He has got a bunch of gear. He also has a giant purple trench coat. He has two portraits, one with the menacing smiling one. He's got another with a fedora. He's got a bunch of, he's got his bang gun, he'll have a cane with a sword in it, suitcase for putting his dynamite sticks, and he also has his fish Joker guns, so he's going to be really, really cool, and I think people get him in hand, they'll be really excited to see this guy. He came out really, really nice, as you can see. So this booth is one I'm really excited about to share with everybody. These are our snow troopers. I've personally been waiting for these guys for a long time, and I'm really excited with how they came out, and really glad to share them with people here today. Snow Trooper is all decked out. It's got his pouches, classic look. We're gonna do the mask in a soft vinyl, so he'll be able to get nice head turns and everything without obstructing the shoulders at all. These are obviously the prototypes, so these are our targets, but we're gonna stay as close to this as we possibly can. And also joining those guys, you have the ability to buy the E-Web Cannon, so you can make your own kind of set diorama if you want to do something as complicated as this. But you can purchase the E-Web Cannon, and the E-Web Cannon will be the turret will move around, will pivot up and down, the generator box, the cable. You can make your own set display and get a couple of snowtroopers and build your army and have your own echo base. All right, going off of Star Wars Expanded Universe, we are doing Darth Malgus, and we are doing Darth Malgus in a couple formats and sharing them with people this year. One of the formats we're doing is our 6-scale. Malgus came out awesome, and we're hoping to make him even more awesome through the production process, but Malgus is all decked out. He's got his cape on the back with his hood that comes up over him. He's got his unique Malgus lightsaber with the blades on it. It's going to come with two portraits. He'll have the portrait where he's scarred with a ventilator. At this time, we're not sure yet the ventilator is going to come off or on, but if I can make it happen, we'll make the ventilator removable. And he'll also have his more unscarred portrait before he came all angry with life. Joining Malgus on our Sith booth is Vader. We're doing Vader again, taking another crack at him. He's got an all new body. It's not the same body we had before. He's a little bit more in scale with a stormtrooper and the rest of the 6-scale line. But he's going to come with a lot of stuff. He'll have a bunch of different hands. He's got a whole new sculpt on the helmet. He'll have a sculpt with a reveal piece that will show his head and his face. He also comes with this two-part helmet display. And you can't actually wear this, but he can hold in his hand stuff with the other helmet that has his face showing. There's detail on the inside of the helmet showing the eye receptors. The helmet, the top of it comes off. You'll have talking two head variations. You'll have the full helmet, you'll see it, and then you'll have the helmet with the reveal. These are just accessory pieces that can be worn by him, but they're just a nice little display on the side, or he can hold it in one of his hands.
And by the resizing, he's a bit smaller than the previous
version. He's a bit smaller than the previous version, so he'll be more in line, and he'll look great next to Boba Fett. So.
Fantastic, okay.
He's got all new cut and sew, a new cape. The cape's a softer material, much more flowing. All right, so yesterday we had a panel with Blizzard, and we unveiled a couple things. One of the things we unveiled was our 6-scale Space Marine of Tychus Findlay. This thing is fully articulated. The fingers move, the knees move, the ankles move, the visor goes up and down, shoulders, elbows. This guy is all decked out and is a behemoth, and he's pretty heavy at this time because he's a prototype, so there's all kinds of parts on him, but he's gonna be a mixed media material. He'll be some metal, perhaps some plastics, and some, and he'll be all painted up. He'll have his visors will go up and down, but this is our expanding into the StarCraft realm, more video game stuff, and this is our first Space Marine 6-scale. His gun's gonna have some crazy features on it. So far, it's been pretty well received yesterday. People were pretty blown away. We were blown away as well with how he came out.
Yeah, he looks
pretty incredible.
And he isn't even painted.
He's not even painted yet.
He isn't even finished.
If he looks good at this level, then he'll even look better once we do the remaining fine tuning on him. But this is a very early prototype, but pretty happy with how he's coming out so far. Another piece we unveiled at Blizzard was our Diablo statue. If you can get a little close, you can see the detail is just insane on this thing. She's sculpted by Brian Fay, I believe. And this thing just came out amazing. And it's gonna be really interesting unpacking her from the package and putting her together, because
such the fine pointy details.
Yeah, I'm sure
all
she'll
over
be
it.
Probably take a little while to assemble her, but she came out just spectacular.
This is a statue.
This is not articulated. Only the Space Marines articulate. This will not be articulated, but this will be pretty pointy with a lot of sharp objects. All right, another piece we have showing at Sideshow Collectibles booth this year is our 1-to-1 Boba Fett. This thing came out spectacular, awesome, and it's been a work in progress for quite a while. One of the guys who worked on it was Alex Alva, and Alex did a lot of the paint on it. Alex, you want to tell him real quick a little bit about the paint, the reference?
Yeah, pretty much we've been doing Fett for a while now, and we use a lot of Lucasfilm reference. We work with the official picks and Philip Wise and Tom Spina Designs to basically match the paint and make it pretty seamless to where every scratch is going to match. Hopefully the production version comes out the same with some of the techniques that we're using.
Yeah, we're gonna do our best to replicate Alex's awesome paint job on this thing, and I think we'll hit the target because we've got a good model to go off of. So we're really, really stoked to show this guy, and he'll have electronic features, and his light box will light up, his base will light up, and there might even be some more stuff that'll be added as we go a little further. But this is our first prototype of him. So there's a little more, a little fine tuning that might occur, but this is the target of what people can look to save up their money for.
Thanks.
Joining the premium format Star Wars line is C-3PO and R2-D2. This has been in the works for a long time. People have been seeing glimpses and hints of them for a while, but here they are. C-3PO is attached to the base. He is articulated from the waist up, so his neck can move around a little bit. His arms can do, the slight moves that C-3PO is able to do with his armor. Is joined by his companion R2-D2. R2-D2 is removable from the base. He is roll around. His third leg does extend in and out. He does light up, as does C-3PO. They are sold as a set. They will be available from Sideshow Collectibles. The target price is $750, and we're looking forward to people really enjoying having these products, as they came out pretty damn nice.
Have electronic features too.
Yeah, they will. They're not on just yet because the show hasn't started, but they will light up and everything, and C-3PO's eyes light up. Joining our Sideshow Original line is Jack the Ripper. This is our Originals line. This is our original idea. This is our concept. And basically the idea behind this is, what did Jack the Ripper see himself as? This is this demonic, sexual, predator, evil being. So this is kind of our story behind this is, how did he see himself? So you can see him with his face just tells a crazy story. Kind of really out there, but really creepy nonetheless. He's got these entrail tentacles coming out, his fingers are all spindly, got this crazy tongue, and a pretty wicked looking cane that's probably not PG rated.
We're looking at a full fabric costume.
Full fabric, man. He's knocked out, and he's got his Victorian London gear for the cold, foggy nights. Blades got some carvings on it, there's some etchings. So old parts of him tell us kind of this crazy story of this less than nice guy. Yeah, a little bit. Okay, so here we have some more stuff we're unveiling right now, and this is our new Predator maquettes, little statues. We have AVP represented. We have AVP, Classic Predator, I'm sorry, AVPR, Predator 2, and then we have another piece, which is not really in any of the movies, but this is a Predator Bad Blood statue based off a kit that was released many, many moons ago, and this is a paint job on him, and we're pretty stoked with him. We have the busts here. We have some more of aliens. We have aliens, alien record, alien 4, and alien 3, and then Big Chap. And that's a bunch of the stuff that are at Comic-Con this year from Sideshow. And we're really glad that you guys were able to make it and join us here today for this.
All right, thanks a lot, Matt. We really enjoyed seeing all of the awesome stuff you guys have coming out. It's amazing how much stuff you guys have worked on.
Yeah.
And we look forward to actually getting our hands on some of this stuff.
Cool, so do I. Thanks a lot, you guys.
Thanks.
Appreciate it.
Take care.